Good afternoon, everyone. My topic of presentation is the correlation of the mammography and with the MRI in evaluation of the breast pathologies. My name is Dr. Anand Deshmukh, GMC Nagpur, GMC Nagpur, JR2. As we know, breast cancer has ranked number one cancer among the breast female females with the age adjust with as rate 25 per 1 lakh women and mortality 12 per 1 lakh women and mortality. Incidence ratio was found to be high. There is 66 in the rural and 18 in the urban. There are multiple health awareness and programs and availability of breast cancer screening programs. They are implemented in our country. That is the main objective and of the study is to characterize the various breast lesions using the different MRI sequences. The difference between the breast benign and malignant lesions with the help of the contrast enhancement curves. To evaluate the accuracy and efficiency of the MRI in the evaluation of breast pathologies. And then this study is conducted in the GMC Nagpur. The source of study, source of cases are the surgery and radiotherapy patients, there is the oncology patients. The sample size is 32 patients with the lump and pain in breast. Then the nipple discharge, nipple extraction, and the high screen patient are included in the study. The patient with the MRI incompatible devices. Then crossover patient, then patient who lost her follow-up, then pregnant and lactating women are excluded from the study. The patient on Philips HEVA machine is used for the MRI. The protocol for the mammography, the patient with the patients evaluated with the mammography with the help of the CCC view, that is craniocaudal view and medial lateral oblique, the MLO view. The CC view is in this patient is stand upright in front of the machine and the breast is positioned in the sandwich sequence technique, that is in MLO position. The X-ray tube is angled with the in the 40 to 60, that and in this study we have used a 30 degree angulations with the horizontal and patient breast. The X-ray tube is parallel to the pectoralis major in the axilla. The protocol for the MRI machine, the patient's position is lying down position, the prone position with the breast hanging freely in the coil apertures, and the topography placed in the center of the coil. The T1, T2 weighted sequences, then T1 fat cell images, then T2 spare images, T2 core images, then diffusion weighted imaging, then T1 contrast image, that is transverse core and SAG imaging are taken. Let's come to the observations of the my studies. And the most of the patients are the female, that is 31 patients, constituting 96% of the study. In this study, then age distribution, most of the patients are in the 41 to 50 years of the age, that constitute 37% patient, that is 12 patients. The clinical presentation, most of the patients are presented with the lump in breast, followed by the pain in breast. The various pathology in our studies, the most common pathologies are detected are the malignant one, that is 15 patients, constituting 46%, then followed by benign, that is 31%. The laterality, most patients are most patients presented with the lesion in the right breast parenchyma, that is 8 patients out of the malignant patients, that is constituting 53% of all malignant patients, malignant lesion with the patients. The locations, most of the patients of the malignant lesions are detected in the outer and upper quadrants, that is 6 patients, that is constitute 40% of the malignant breast tumors. The detection and FNSC, detection on the FNSC and histopathology, most of the malignant patients detected on the FNSC test, that is 13 patients, that is out of 15 patients, are detected on the FNSC, and 2 of them are the indeterminate or the negative patients. Then fibroadenoma are also detected on the FNSC, 5 out of 5 patients. The fibrocystic fibrocystic diseases, FNSC come positive in the 1 patient and negative on the 2 patients. The abscesses and lipoma also detected on the FNSC detection. MRI enhancement types, there are 3 types. There is no enhancement, there is mass-like or non-mass-like. The mass-like enhancement are the most common pattern of the enhancement, that is 43% of the cases out of 32 patients. Then type of the mass-like enhancement, there are three type of non-enhancement, that is homogeneous enhancement, and there are heterogeneous enhancement and Riemann enhancement. The most of the malignant lesions, malignant breast tumors are heterogeneous type of enhancement. Then three of the patients, that 20% out of 15 patients, they are homogeneously enhancing, and their fibroadenoma, they're also heterogeneous and homogeneous enhancement. In our study, the heterogeneous are the most common type of the enhancement pattern in the malignant tumors, and heterogeneous enhancement may also present in the 40% of the fibroadenomas. Then a type of the curves, the most type 3 enhancement curves is most commonly seen in malignant lesions. That is 80% of the patients out of 15 patients, that is 12 patients. In our study, 12 out of 15 patients with the malignant tumors showed type 3 enhancement curves, and 3 patients showed type 2 enhancement curves. That is majority of the malignant lesions showed type 3 curve. The diffusion restriction, the most of the patients show the diffusion restriction are the malignant breast tumors. Then 4 of the patients shows do not show the diffusion restriction. Then fibroadenoma also do not show diffusion restriction. The mammographic findings, here there is a malignant type of the breast tumors. There is a aggressive pattern of the calcification seen. Also, there is a benign pattern also seen in some of the malignant patients. Narcular distortion mostly seen in the 14 patients, and the asymmetry also seen in the 8 patients. Fibroadenomas are mostly most of the circumscribed margins. Also, there is a microcystic adhesive. They show the micro where circumscribed margin as shown in the chart. Here come to the cases. Case one is a 66-year-old female patient with the complaint of lump and tenderness in the right breast. Here is a high density lesion noted in the right breast parenchyma, which showing the archital distortion, and there is no evident calcific foci noted within. On UAG correlation, there is a relatively well-defined hypoechoic lesion noted in the right breast parenchyma, not taking internal vascularity. This is taller than wider, showing the malignant neoplastic etiology. On MRI, let's come to the MRI. There is a relatively well-defined microlobulated lesion noted in the right breast parenchyma, which is hypo on T1 T2 weighted images and homogeneously enhancing. On histopathological examination, show ductal carcinomas. On case two, the 55 years old female come with the complaint of a lump in trabe base associated with the tenderness since 1 month without any fever. There is a large high density lesion noted in the left breast parenchyma. However, right breast parenchyma appears normal, or the type B type of the breast parenchyma. There is a high density. There is hypoechoic lesion noted in the large hypoechoic lesion, well defined hypoechoic lesion noted in the left breast parenchyma, noting into vascularity, multiple moving echoes. And on MRI correlation, there is a relatively well-defined large lesion already in the left breast parenchyma, which appears hyperintense on T1, hyperintense on T2 and STIR. Then showing the peripheral contrast, post-contrast enhancement with the solid intramural enhancement nodule, which showing septations. Which is this is a polyproductive breast disease with atypia. Let's come to the third case. That is 51-year-old female who complains of the cyclical pain in the left breast. On the mammography, there is a type C type of the breast parenchyma, which is obliterating the lesions in the breast parenchyma. But so we have proceeded with the UHG, and there is a hypoechoic lesion noted in the right breast parenchyma, left breast parenchyma, which is not significantly taking internal vascularity, and there is a not any calcium foci noted within. On the MRI sequences, there is a relatively well-defined round oval lesion noted in the left breast parenchyma, which is hypo-intense on T1, hyper-intense on T2 and STIR, is showing the mild peripheral enhancement on the post-contrast administration and showing the type 1 enhancement curves. On HPE correlation, this lesion is suggestive of fibrocystic disease, that is a benign breast lesion. Let's come to discussion. In prospective comparison, mammography, sonography, and MRI in a patient in the study undergoing study conducted by the Iran et al. 41 patient underwent physical examination, mammography, and breast sonography and breast MRI before and after administration of the contrast administration of each chemotherapeutic agents. MRI agents are able to correctly diagnose 71% cases and underestimate 23% as compared to the mammography. The tumor size is also more accurately depicted with the MRI versus mammography. In present study, MRI was able to correctly diagnose 65% of the cases opposed to the 48% in mammo. MRI is also is used strictly used as complementary to the mammography. Then quantitative assessment of the MRI, quantitative assessment of the type of the contrast enhancement, kinetic curves on the breast, dynamic contrast enhancement MRI, resulting in significant higher diagnostic performances in evaluating the breast malignancy of the lesion. The dynamic contrast enhanced breast MRI includes multi-phase T1 weighted images pre-contrast, early phase post-contrast, delayed phase post-contrast, and analysis of the contrast uptake allows the MRI to assess the kinetics characteristic of the lesion. MRI is the most powerful tool to detect the lesion as compared to the conventional imaging. Then breast MRI is also better at the monitoring the response to the chemotherapy. And mammography is only imaging study that has been proven in the multiple large randomized trials to decrease the breast cancer mortality. Breast MRI should not be used instead of mammography. It is strictly the complementary to the other imaging modalities. These are my references. Thank you.